Hi guys, it's Bailey. I know that this isn't the way that we were expecting or hoping to come together this week to kick off this series for our Christmas series, Silent Night. But let me just say, I am so excited about the opportunity to still come together with you guys, to still seek God and to go through this series, because this is something we've been praying about for a while as leadership. And so we're just excited for what God's gonna do in your lives, in our lives, and through this series. And so I'm just glad that we continue to be able to get together and do this. And let me also say too, I know that things haven't looked the way that we thought they would or should with COVID, but this has provided a unique opportunity for something that we probably wouldn't have done otherwise. Tonight, we're gonna kick off this series a little differently. And before I dive into that, I wanna talk about Pastor Dale's message this past weekend. If you guys missed it, go back and watch it for main service on Sunday. It was so good. And if you saw it, you know how good it was. But he had this illustration of boxes. And funnily enough, I was kind of gonna do the same thing in service this week if we had it in person. I was gonna have these boxes because he was talking about worries and how they can build up in our lives. But we're looking at silence, which can be a scary thing. If you guys are 21 Pilots fans, you know, sometimes quiet is violent. It's this idea that silence is an uncomfortable thing, something that we're not wanting to deal with, wanting to be around, wanting to have. And that happens in our lives a lot. And I've been reading this book. A lot of you guys would recognize this name, Eric Samuel Tim, Static Jedi. And he talks about noise, how we can have so many voices in our lives, how we can hear one person speaking out if they're talking to us. But as we continue to add voices, we eventually can't pick a single one out. But we need to be able to hear that single voice of God. It all becomes noise and we can't let him become noise. And so it says here that we are living in a time where hearing from God is bombarded by frequencies and voices. The noise, corrosive in nature. I love that imagery. Makes it difficult to hear God's voice. Living with more noise means we live less like a disciple. And so Eric Samuel Tim says, figure out how much noise you have. All right. So every hour, we have a lot of boxes like these. So I'm using this instead of Home Depot boxes. But we have a lot of boxes like this around right now. With this season, these are the boxes we have. But imagine each box is an hour. Right? Doesn't seem like that big of a deal with noise. But imagine you have 2 hours of noise a day. Noise being time that we're scrolling, checking, clicking, just piddling, like just going through, bending our necks to our phones, whether it's even just texting, participating in a conversation, sentence by sentence, line by line. Time that we are participating in what is the noise, whether that's social media, whether that is conversations that aren't happening face-to-face, even if that face-to-face is through a screen right now, right? These moments, these hours, these minutes. And Eric Singleton says, if you just spend 2 hours, which I think is pretty conservative, especially during COVID times, that would mean that approximately one whole month out of each year of your life is invested in noise. One whole month out of 1 year. And if you keep, you know, adding that up, it ends up in one decade, we fall just shy of losing an entire year of our life to the noise. And that's only at 2 hours a day. 2 hours a day can take up a whole year of your life out of 10 years. That's 10% of that time. But guys, this series, we're going to be intentional about slowing down. We're going to be intentional about silencing ourselves, quieting ourselves, because we know that Christmas can be loud. This isn't just a plain box. This is a box of holiday noise, noise that maybe we think is helping us. And Eric Samuel Tim actually has a quote about that too that I loved, because he says, as you're looking at it, right, we justify our actions and the interactions with noise as educational or relationally productive. Is it? How do you know? How can you be sure? And so I want us to not justify noise. And so tonight, whether you are watching this on your computer, on your phone, however you're watching this, wherever you're watching this, I want you to remove yourself from people. I want you, this is not going to take long. Just go and be by yourself. Take that time to be by yourself, because what we're going to dive into tonight is intentional. It is purposeful. We're going to be looking at the Christmas story intentionally in a quiet manner, in a way that helps us to silence the noise, whether it be in our minds, in our hands, get rid of those notifications. Just quiet yourself before God. We're going to be reading through the Christmas story. You're going to hear some of your peers, some of your leaders reading scripture in a couple different versions. There's going to be some songs for us to reflect on and kind of think through, some questions to prompt some things. So if you want to pull out a journal, or if you just want to have your phone, you know, your light all the way dimmed, whatever that is that's going to help you focus on this, please do that. Just take a deep breath in. Get rid of all that stress. Don't think about the homework that you have due today or tomorrow. Just for this time, be present here. Don't engage the noise. Because God speaks in still small voices. And if we're too busy wrapped up in the noise, we miss it. And we don't want to miss it. We want to live like disciples. We don't want to be disciples to the noise, but disciples to the God of still small voices, who uses the still small voice of a baby to be the savior to the world. And so just quiet yourselves. And I just want to pray for us before we dive into this today, that God would meet us wherever we are, and that he would speak to us in a new way through a story that has become very, very familiar. Let's pray though. God, thank you so much for today. Thank you for all of these students, these leaders that have been a part of this, but also that are participating in this now. God, I just pray that you would speak to us, that you would meet us where we are at, whether that's our bedroom, our kitchen table by ourselves, our car, wherever we find ourselves. God, I just pray that you would help us to block out the noise, that you would help us to focus on you and to hear your voice, to hear the story of your son being born, the savior of the world, the one who was the ultimate sacrifice for our sins. God, I just pray that this familiar story would become unfamiliar, that we would hear it with new ears, that we would place ourselves in the story through these prompts and questions, that we would participate in it with you. But God, I just pray that you would meet us in this silence, meet us in this quiet, and that we would hear your still small voice. I pray that you would honor this intentionality of each student, just taking time out of the noise to participate and listen for you. But God, we just pray that you'd bless this time and bless this season as we begin to celebrate and look towards Christmas and the birth of Jesus. But we love you, and it's in your name we pray. Amen. Well, guys, I am so excited for this. So like I said, take a deep breath, get comfy, but not too comfy. Get your journals, get your Bibles. Let's do this together.
So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them.
So Joseph went from the Galilean town of Nazareth up to Bethlehem in Judah, David's town, for the census. As a descendant of David, he had to go there. He went with his fiancée, who was pregnant. While they were there, the time came for her to give birth. She gave birth to a son, her firstborn. She wrapped him in a blanket and laid him in a manger because there was no room in the hostel.
Imagine you are Joseph preparing a place in the animal stable for your fiance to give birth. How do you feel? What do you say to Mary?
Picture yourself as either Joseph or Mary right after Jesus' birth. What do you say to each other? How do you put into words what just happened?
So Joseph went from the Galilean town of Nazareth up to Bethlehem in Judah, David's town, for the census. As a descendant of David, he had to go there. He went with Mary, his fiancée, who was pregnant. While they were there, the time came for her to give birth. She gave birth to a son, her firstborn. She wrapped him in a blanket and laid him in a manger because there was no room in the hostel.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger."
There were sheep herders camping in the neighborhood. They had set night watches over their sheep. Suddenly, God's angel stood among them, and God's glory blazed around them. They were terrified. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. I'm here to announce a great and joyful event that is meant for everybody worldwide. A Savior has just been born in David's town, a Savior who is Messiah and Master. This is what you are to look for, a baby wrapped in a blanket and lying in a manger."
Imagine you're one of these shepherds. What would be your first thoughts when you saw the angel?
The angel speaks of good news, great joy, a Savior. What do you think this message means?
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger."
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about."
At once the angel was joined by a huge angelic choir singing God's praises. "Glory to God in the heavenly heights. Peace to all men and women on earth who please him." As the angel choir withdrew into heaven, the sheep herders talked it over. "Let's get over to Bethlehem as fast as we can and see for ourselves what God has revealed to us."
The angels proclaimed glory to God and peace to all. Does the birth of Jesus make you want to glorify God?
Have you seen Jesus bring peace to your life?
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the new.
Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord told us about."
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told to them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them.
They left, running, and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. Seeing was believing. They told everyone they met what the angels had said about this child. All who heard the sheepherders were impressed.
As one of the shepherds, what do you think of the baby Jesus when you see him?
They told everyone about Jesus. How can you spread the good news about Jesus today?
Do you think people are still amazed when they hear that God came to earth as a little baby?
Shepherds kept their watching, O silent flocks by night. Behold, throughout the heavens, there shone a holy light. Shone a holy light. Shepherds feared and trembled when low above the earth rang out the angel's chorus that hailed the Savior's birth. Go tell it on the mountains, over the hills, and everywhere. Yeah, go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born today.
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them.
But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Mary kept all these things to herself, holding them dear, deep within herself. The sheepherders returned and let loose, glorifying and praising God for everything they had heard and seen. It turned out exactly the way they'd been told.
Take time to ponder in your heart the meaning of Christmas.
Commit to God that this season you will glorify and praise Him, like the angels, like the shepherds, like Mary.
Mm-hmm. nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and heaven and nature sing.
But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.